It is a scene no police department ever wants to be a part of.
Today at 1:40 p.m., officers were dispatched to a disturbance in the...
Tonight, the Mesquite Police Department had to do the heartbreaking act of a school...
He was a 21-year veteran in the Mesquite Police Department. He was a good man, a good friend, a good officer.
This house has never been this quiet.
It was always loud, even if he was the only one here.
He was my make it better person, and now I don't have that make it better person.
I don't know how to describe it other than it hit different, and it hit home, and it hit hard.
Losing Officer Richard Houston was especially hard because there was just so much of him to lose.
Everything he loved 110%.
You know, when you dabble in things, you just, you know, kind of try things out. No, we had to have the best paints, all the brushes.
It may only last a week, but it's going to be the best of the best.
I can't tell you how many, pocket knives I have found.
Oh, the books, too.
Oh, the books.
Oh, and if they had a signature, that was even better.
But there was one time in high school when he didn't give his best.
Mr. Klein's not going to love this one when he hears this. We both play trumpet. He knew I wasn't good enough to be at the top. He was. So he just started bombing all his tests so he could always sit at the back with me.
I always think of Richard as having this little sly grin on his face. Nothing bad, but he just had that look in his eye that something was up.
You never could get a straight picture of him because he's always doing something. You're smiling, smirking.
As goofy as he was, probably one of the most mature, responsible kids our age, because he was partially helping to raise his siblings.
Richard was in high school when his father died.
This was his dad and him in their cowboy hats, because he idolized them.
Between that experience and knowing the risks of our profession, Richard lived every moment to its fullest.
We could have stopped at a gas station, yes, and he would have pulled out his phone to take a family picture.
Richard was open with his own kids about losing his dad.
From the moment I met him in high school, he's always kept a journal.
As the children get older, I feel like I should do something for them in the event that I won't be around.
When his father passed, and over the years, there have been so many things that he wondered about his dad or wanted to ask his father. And so his purpose in this was for his children.
He couldn't have known it at the time, but that helped prepare Shelby for his eulogy.
And tell us about some crazy car chase he got into, or maybe even how terrible the 7-Eleven taquitos were for lunch.
I knew that that was what I was supposed to be doing, and I know that those words are the words I was supposed to be saying. I just was really confident that the Lord had placed that on my heart.
18 years with you, Daddy, was just not enough time.
He's impacted his family. I think you look at his family and you will know Richard.
There's probably no greater testament to a man's life than looking at his family.
In 21 years on the force, Officer Houston received over 50 commendations, including 2 life-saving awards.
To be able to work in the city that we grew up in and have the kind of legacy that he leaves now, I'm envious of that. I think his father would be really proud.
I knew he was did his best in everything he did, but I didn't realize he had touched as many people as he had until his funeral.
Be all in, and whatever it is that you love, whether it's your family or it's a hobby, be all in.